the dreams that we once had. This is the time to bring them back. What would the promise say? Caught on the tips of our tongues. Do we forget or forgive? There's a whole lot of life waiting to live when one day we're brave enough to talk with conviction of the heart. Down your streets I've walked alone, as if my feet were not my own. Such is the path I chose. Doors I have opened and closed. I'm tired of living this life, fooling myself, believing.
The race is on to save the planet from hazardous waste dump to ozone depletion, from destruction of tropical rainforests to all manners of air and water pollution. The race is on to protect our environment. It's a matter of our very own survival. But there's a critical shortage of team players, especially minorities and women. Hi, I'm Hank Aaron. When I was growing up, I knew that being a minority in baseball was going to be a big challenge. In 1974, I hit my 715th home run and broke baseball's most cherished record. It was one of the greatest moments in my life, as well as in baseball history. In order to meet that challenge, I had to prepare myself to seize every opportunity. Being prepared was the key for me, and it will be the key for you.
The most important thing for us to do is to address the shortage of minorities in the sciences and engineering as a whole. Now, Clark Atlanta University has in fact been trying over the last few years, in fact the last decade for that matter, to do something about the shortage of minorities in the sciences and engineering. To do that, we have developed a whole range of programs that go from pre-college to undergraduate to graduate programs. We think that the problem is a pipeline issue. Before students get to college, unfortunately for many minority students, they drop out of the critical disciplines that are needed to pursue a degree at the undergraduate level in the sciences and engineering. Principally, algebra, trig, communication skills, all of those very critical disciplines that are needed for careers in the sciences. Unfortunately, minority students coming to college are not well prepared in those areas.
The careers in environmental sciences, you know, are very good careers. They are actually in great need for the nation. It is a way actually to help others and to help your neighborhood, your community, your state, you know, your country. And actually it's it could be a beautiful commitment that a young person can do and say, I'm going to make the difference, we can make the difference, and at the same time, you know, be happy and make good money and just have success in life.
While environmental career opportunity mushroom, too few students are taking the steps to make a difference. Too few young people are seeking the proper training.
environmental engineering or environmental careers are relatively new. I don't know in the last, 10 years, I'm just guessing, but it's increasingly become one of the most important topics here in the United States and all over the world. And that if they are creative enough and if they apply themselves enough, they could be one of those individuals who revolutionize the world of environmental engineering.
This is a story about the birds and the bees, the flowers and the trees, the dying of disease, disease that affects the whole human race. Yeah. Kick in the drums and turn up the bass, right, and listen to the words that I bring with an underground swing. We gotta start preserving the green, not the money that we earn, but the trees that we burn. Yeah. People of my generation gotta get concerned. Yeah. Spend a couple of minutes just to think about the ozone. The world needs a layer of protection like the cap on your dome. We need a new solution, cause natural evolution will be a fall of confusion if we don't act quick. See, I'm getting kinda sick of all the cronies in the office reaping in the profits. Word. From the shore in the great wide open, nature's choking, and I'm only hoping we help out the motherland, cause there will be no other land to take its place. It's a big disgrace. See, you drinking Coca-Cola and you drop the empty can on the ground. King little bug, it's time to get crowned. So this is for the brothers and the sisters to dance to, but it's for the lands and the waters and the plants too. Word. Cause they're the ones dying, yeah. Mother Nature's crying, and EPA is trying, but all my friends are lying, yeah, about the things they say they're gonna do. But what they really think is true, uh-huh, is nature's the problem and his solution. Rainforest fires and air pollution. So don't let your friends rule your life and try to say that you're whack. Nature gave it to you, it's time to give back. Get a grip, come equipped, sober up, and make a brand new start. This is a conviction of the heart.
Come on, yeah. Ooh, yeah. It's more than just a jam, it's a conviction of the heart.
We've all seen high school and college athletes training, learning and practicing their skills, setting and reaching their goals, and rising above their own expectations while developing a team spirit. The difference between the average sports enthusiast and one aspiring to a career in sports, such as baseball or football, is a commitment to excellence.
Speaking from the standpoint of the environment, we are the only ones in this country that can clean this rock up. We're the only ones. There's nobody else that can do it. And the problem, some of the problems that we run into is the fact that, are we really interested in doing it? Do we really have the wherewithal and the know-how to get it cleaned up?
Well, with sports, I think you have to have a real solid foundation in terms of building fundamentals and growing towards accomplishing a goal, which is winning. In the environmental area, we have our earth, and we're all here to defend the earth, and we got to play defense. And when I say play defense, we must move forward with programs, but those programs must be environmentally sensitive. And I think the people who are going to guard our earth are going to be environmental professionals.
It is important that we all become a part of the earth team, because we live on this planet, the only ones that can clean it up. That's minorities, that's Hispanics, that's you name it. Everyone that's involved in the environment needs to be involved in our team.
Commitment to excellence is a decision to reach for the stars, work harder, sacrifice many hours, and become a tear. This holds true for sports as well as for any other career you choose.
Being in an environmental career is special because everything that you do is working towards environmental preservation. And it doesn't matter where you're doing it, but you're really trying to make the earth a better place to live.
We have been making contributions to America in other areas, so this is another area that hopefully we will take the opportunity, not have it given to us. We will seize the opportunity and move forward and make the environmental commitment a minority commitment to an enhanced America.
The environmental movement, very much like the civil rights movement, does not operate on a win-lose basis. It operates on a win-win basis. When a community decides and finds a way to strengthen its own environmental laws, when it begins to protect its businesses, and when its businesses get equally concerned about protecting the environment, then everybody's going to win.
It's more than just a jam, it's a conviction of the
Yo,
heart.
Trees are getting cut everywhere. People seem to do it and they don't even care. The trees give the oxygen you breathe through your nose. The walls of the speakers who accentuate the lows. And they provide food for koalas and giraffes. Or else we wouldn't have the color green on the map. Like my man Jeep Left said in the first verse, you gotta give back. You never know when smoking a bear's gonna check. Just like Michael Jordan goes to the hoop, I'm delivering the scoop to all the chickens in the coop. How low will you stoop to the vice versa loop?
Billy D can't be duped and he's never ever souped.
Now if you see aluminum cans scattered on the green, just take them to your nearby recycling machine. You get 25 cents a pound for your work and you never get hurt. Plant a tree in the dirt and watch it grow to the sky. Or the yellow river's never gonna get tired. You never heard a song called Tie Yellow Ribbon by the old oak stump. And if you did, then you a punk. Here is something I can't understand.
How we can just kill the land.
Yeah. Extra, extra, emergency is urgent. The fish are gonna die because of the industry detergent. Oh man, I forgot to talk about the water. To every mother, father, brother, sister, son, and daughter. Supplies getting strapped, so turn off the tap. You say you don't know Jack, well yo, you need to step back. Cause it's whack. And diggity dumb and siggity soft and pootin' and wiggity what? Do mind on me and say you can't do much. Cause if you could return a bottle, you would be a role model. If you could collect again, you would be a better man. So save the planet, it's your goal, pursue it. Don't try to say it in a rhyme, man, just do it. Cause life is like a movie, everybody plays a part. It's more than just a jam, it's a conviction of the heart.
It's more than just a jam, it's a conviction of the heart.
A recent report found that in order to meet the future needs for environmental scientists and engineers, the number of African Americans pursuing bachelor degrees would have to triple, and the number pursuing doctorate degrees would have to increase 16-fold. The student with the right academic preparation can pretty much write his or her own ticket, but not enough minorities are choosing environmental careers. In order for the planet to survive and thrive, we need to protect the environment and make it safe and healthy for everyone. But the need is so great, no one group alone can do the job. Our Earth team must include more African Americans, Hispanics, Native Americans, Asians, as well as Caucasian to do the job well. Public agencies and private corporations realize that cultural diversity is a key in reaching all areas ravished by environmental damage.
We are truly dedicated to diversifying the workforce at Amoco. We adhere to the year 2000 diversity issue, and we are trying to attract as many highly qualified minorities into the Amoco organization that we can possibly.
We have a large base of people of color, women in our staff ranks. Also, we're finding that in our managerial ranks, certainly in mid-management levels, the numbers of minorities and women have been increasing. The focus currently is on improving the number of both women and minority at the very senior levels of the company, and that's being addressed now.
The United States Army is one organization that has a history of cultural diversity. Its recent initiative, based on environmental protection and responsibility, affirms its commitment to become a leader in environmental management. This has resulted in a dire need for trained personnel. In a sense, we are at war with ourselves. And our chief victims are poor and minority communities. But environmental problems know no boundaries. Eventually, they affect everyone. Pollution has no concern for rich or poor, black or white. It's everywhere.
Environmental problems in this country disproportionately impact low income and communities of color, whether it's landfills, incinerators, toxic waste dumps, lead smelters. These problems have been around for a long time. They're just now becoming at the forefront of environmental policy making. And it's time to address some of these problems and to have policymakers consider them top agenda items.
I need you in EPA because in order to make a change, we have to have the people there that can work with us to get into key positions, to relate to the communities that have been disfranchised.
I heard that there's a lot being done and there's a lot of people joining together to combat environmental racism, combat hazardous waste being dumped into our neighborhoods. And I see people who have gone on and are running this race and are making it. And this is just so wonderful to me.
Too many years of digging now. Isn't it time to stop somehow? Air that's too angry to breathe. Water our children can't drink. You've heard it hundreds of times. Say you're aware, believe that you care. But do you care enough? Where's your conviction? The
environmental careers are not only critical to our survival, they are in high demand. They are fun, exciting, and they command top salaries. Career and educational opportunities are increasing rapidly as industry responds to the urgent need to find solutions.
The largest employers, you know, of our graduates, you know, are basically AT&T, Florida Power and Light, Southern Bell, and biomedical or medical companies in the area. Many of our graduates, too, because of the demand, they move to the West Coast or they go northeast to other companies that do require. We have quite a few of the women that graduated in the program. They are now at NASA here in Cape Kennedy.
Clearly, in environmental chemistry and environmental engineering, there are many, many job opportunities. And these job opportunities, maybe the exciting thing that I find with environmental chemistry, as opposed to some of the traditional chemistry fields, is that you have an opportunity to go outside and get out of the laboratory and study in the field, and then you can combine your field work with laboratory work.
Well, I'm sure I want to go into engineering. I'm not sure what field, but that's what's good about engineering, because they have a large field, and if you're not satisfied with one field, you can easily go to another one.
Earth Team is building its coalition in government and community organizations, in private industry, and on college campuses. At Florida International University in Miami, students are learning about exciting careers in science and engineering by participating in the Florida Action for Minorities in Engineering program, otherwise known as FLAME.
The entire concept of FLAME had to do with how we could enrich the lives of kids and education opportunities. The engineering field itself did not have very many blacks entering into it. And from year to year, there would be monies available for scholarships that would be left over where no one claimed it. And we have a lot of bright, young, black kids in our system, and we saw this as a chance to break into a school like Coral Park, these young, bright minds, take care of their basic needs, educational needs, and at the same time send them over to the university to receive hands-on experiences in the field of engineering.
I decided to participate because it gives you like a chance to interact with other engineers. And for us, the 12th graders, we go to FIU, so we do college work, and we have hands-on experience, you know, with other engineers.
Well, we get to build many projects, such as
alarms. We get to build catapults that we have to calculate the angles and set up targets. We also do some other fun stuff like egg drops and try to build a container to protect the egg before it hits the ground.
Well, you learn how to build very, very interesting things like cars and bridges, and then you get a head start in college, which is very important.
I like to build things a lot because they're always giving us things we have to build and math problems. I like math a lot. I like solving problems.
It does help that if you are creative, if you like to imagine things, anything you can think of to make a practical use for it, that's engineering.
As you have seen throughout this program, there are a few things you can do early on to prepare yourself for an environmental career. First, take the appropriate math and science courses. Second, explore environmental science and engineering programs like FLAME at your school, a local college, a university. Third, contact some colleges and universities that may offer environmental degrees. Fourth, gather information about environmental careers. Let's talk about one way you can do this. The Environmental Careers Organization sponsors an annual conference which provides students with an invaluable opportunity to learn about careers and network with professionals. Our environment, it is everywhere we work, live, and play. It affects the air we breathe, the water we drink, and the food we eat. It impacts Earth inhabitants around the globe, even those yet unborn. There have never been more rewarding opportunities, and there has never been a more important time to join the race to save our planet than right now. So many people come to watch the game, but I appeal to you to get involved and don't just stand in the batter's box. Take a swing, hit a home run for the environment.